Hello, art lovers.
This is art.
Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Wile E. Coyote, genius.
And this is Smart.
And this is...
Art Smart!
Hi boys and girls, welcome to Art Smart. This is a lesson that involves drawing and painting. The name of the lesson is Crayon Resist. It's a lesson where you actually use crayon. A lot of you have done this at the South Lawrence East School in my lessons. It's a lesson where you use crayon with black paint. What happens is you use the crayon and you press down very hard. After you're done pressing down very hard with the crayon, you put a watercolor black tempera paint on top. What happens is that the black paint resists the crayon because the crayon is made out of wax. A lot of people in a lot of grades use this type of a lesson. A lot of people will say to me, "Hi, Mr. Cap, that's baby stuff using crayons." But I, as a teacher, still use crayon resist in a lot of my posters and designs as well. If you look up here, you can see I did this, drawing, painting, sculpturing, which looks like it's about to fall off, is all done in crayon resist. The crayon is done first, pressing down very hard, and then the black paint is put on top. Notice how the color crayon comes right through. Still comes right through to the black, through the black paint. If you step over here, I'll show you a couple of other samples of a crayon resist project done by the sixth grade and seventh grade. Okay, boys and girls, here you can see that this is some of the lessons that some of the boys and girls did over here at the South Lawrence East School. I call these focal point drawings because what happens is, here's one that's unfinished, okay, is that you start out with a design in the middle, like a red circle, work your way through adding a lot of color and different things to make a wheel. And if you look, the focal point starts in the center of each one, and it's a real beautiful type of a design, which looks pretty plain, kind of boring, until you're able to put black paint on top of it. Now, part of this lesson really calls for a lot of detail. Detail, in the other word, is using the crayons, dibujar. And a lot of the Spanish kids have taught me, dibujar means pressing down very hard with a crayon. One thing you have to realize is, if you don't press down hard enough with the crayon, the black paint will go over it and will actually just cover the crayon. The more you press down, the more wax you get on a piece of paper. So you can see a lot of details. Here, this person put down, his name is Warner, and what he did was he put respect. So this is actually part of our logo, or our motto for the South Lawrence East School, is reading, respect, and responsibility. So you can see respect right here. You can see different colors, different designs, and all of this. And you can see people's names of some of the kids that worked. There's Victor, there's Juan. All these different kids did this themselves, this project. Here is Susan's, Carlos. Here are all these different colors, all these different ones, done on a piece of paper, and after it's painted, they're cut out. They're just taped to the wall. If you look right here, you can see again that you need a lot more detail before you even attempt to do this lesson. Again, pressing down very, very hard. I'll show you what you need for this lesson in order to start. You need what's called tempera paint. This can be bought in an art store. This is the name of a company that's on Route 128 in Burlington called Charette. This is called Crayola Tempera Black Paint. or you can go to an art store and you can get that. Now somebody asked me as well, Mr. Cap, will watercolor work? Watercolors, they will, as long as you get a good amount of the black. The only color you use is black for this lesson. Other colors will not work as effective. And you'll have a real contrast of color if you stick with the black as the different colors of crayon comes through the paper. What I will show you right here now are the crayons that you need. You need all bright color crayons. And I actually use the So Big crayons. And a lot of first grade, second grade have those giant crayons called the Crayola, the So Big. I like them because they really have a lot of color. They don't snap as easy. And if you break one, that's okay because it means you're pressing down hard enough. You need a good piece of white drawing paper. In your school, ask your art teacher, can I have a piece of paper and try this lesson? Ask them for a drawing paper. Okay, the paper that is in the classroom is what you need, a thick, thick type of a paper. Now, what I did was I am showing you right now an example of how this is done. So I'm going to show you two different drawings here. And I'm going to show you one. This is called a repeated pattern, where you actually do one triangle all the way across, cartwheels all the way across, lines all the way across. And when the repeated pattern continues, it creates a sense of a design. Same thing right here. Repeated pattern. Circle in the middle, eye goes to the focus point, circle, spokes, colors, circles, blues, reds. Can you tell me what's the only crayon you would not use in this lesson? That would be black, bokeh, because black is the black color of the paint. Anything you do in black will not show up. You can use brown, you can use any other color except black. So let's look at this right now and see. Here is one that Mr. Cap did, okay? And he did one here, dibujar. Thanks to all my friends that taught me some of these Spanish words that I did not know, pressing down hard is very important. And that word again is pressing down hard, dibujar. But it's as hard as you can go, because here is one that's not as hard pressed down. So this is A, this is B. You can tell which one is pressed down much harder. Look at the color intensity, or the intensity of the color, I should say. Look at how bright the colors are. This isn't pressed down hard enough. And that's what we want to show, A and is B. Now, some of the kids will ask me in class, Mr. Cap, do we use it right out of the bottle? The answer is no. You have to dilute the bottle, the black paint. And what you have to do, boys and girls, is you have to get a little jar and pour some of this in and mix it with water. But what you have to also do is don't make a beautiful picture without experimenting with the consistency of the black paint. Because if you end up making a nice picture and all of a sudden you have too much black and not enough water, the black will just bury the color, and you've lost your whole picture. Take a practice piece of paper. So you would go like this. Take a practice piece of paper and try a color, even before you attempt to put the paint on the paper. So what you do is you take some of the black, you pour it in, and you add some water. You just add water, and here's what you do. You don't scrub, but you go very light. And if you go very, very light, it would work. It will work. However, if you scrub down very hard, it'll disappear. Here is one that was not pressed down hard enough that I did. And some boys and girls will actually use it like a windshield wiper on a car, and they'll go back and forth like that, and look what happens. Now, let's see what happens when we go on to the finished one here. Let's see what happens when we are all set with the water and what we want to use, the right consistency of water. Remember, do a practice one first. Barely touch the paper, and look what happens. As you barely touch the paper, now that means not scrubbing with your brush. If you scrub with the brush, then
you're going to lose a lot of your color. So what you do is you go very, very lightly, and also move along, stay away from the same spot, because you can see that the crayon is fighting the black paint, and you just want it to do that. But the more you keep rubbing, the more you can rub the wax off, and the black paint can go on top, because you're not going to get 100% crayon in some areas. But if you look real close, you can see there, and that's what happens when it's finished. So you can do all sorts of things, pressing down hard again, and look at this. This actually starts to show up. The more you press down with the crayon, the more the crayon will work for you. You can see like that. So if you tried your name, somebody in the other class tried it and did Carlos, L-O-S, like that, you can notice that if you try it again, let's see what happens here. C-A-R-L-O-S. But the only other thing is you have to watch for is how boring it is just blue. Decorate it. Use bright colors. Use a lot of bright colors. Now remember this one that I did very lightly? I did not press down hard. And look what happens. The crayon totally did not come through, so you have a black square. This is just a couple of examples of a lesson of what you can actually do. And now what I will do is I will show you what you can make out of these crayon resist lessons as far as a greeting card and a pencil holder for the design. Here we are a couple of days later in Art Smart in the art room at the South Lawrence East School with some of the projects that were completed by students in the crayon resist medium. So if you see here, I'll show you a couple of examples of what we're working on here. You know, a lot of the kids will say, Mr. Kapp, what can we do? What can we make with these things? Well, here's one of them, is actually taking a piece of paper with a pencil holder, supply holder, brushes, scissors, ruler, and actually cutting the piece of paper after it's dry and pasting it on a coffee can. Get a really nice holder here for a holiday gift. And another one is a greeting card using a piece of oak tag, hard cardboard, you can get it from your teachers, cutting your picture, putting a little white border around it, using black construction paper, you can create some kind of a card, stand-up greeting card. Another project that some of the kids are doing here at the South Lawrence East School is a journal cover. So again, using a piece of cardboard, folding the cardboard in half, cutting the paper to the square that it would fit on the cover, stapling it, stands up by itself, would be for journals. And another project that we're working on here is with calendars here. So you can see a crayon resist picture and a calendar at the bottom here. So you can see all around there are some real interesting things that you can use and to create with crayon resist. I want to thank you for tuning in and watching this lesson here, and come up with your own ideas. You know, what can you make out of this crayon resist? Can it just be a picture? Can it be a functional object? Again, can it be something like this? The calendar, the pencil holder, the journal cover, or the greeting card? It's up to you. Remember, you're in Art Smart, and let's see how... Here we are a couple of weeks later in Art...
A couple days later, not a couple of weeks.
All right. Okay, tell me...
This is Channel 48, television for Lawrence Public Schools.